Hey guys, and welcome to the new comic book picker video. Things the lads and stuff I got from Past and Present. So we're going to show you that stuff. First thing I'm going to show you is the two comics I got from a different event. There's different booths there, kind of. Each one's like a different person. But the two comics I got from a different booth. I'll show those first. I got this one, Justice Society of America, issue 1. This is the series that came after the other one. I got a bunch of JSAs from the other guy at the booth. And JSA, Society of America, is the series after that. It's also written by Geoff Johns. He wrote the beginning of it. A good chunk of the beginning of it. And then it got off to somebody else. But it was cool. The series was still cool. It was cool. I actually made this comic kind of paint. Made the multiple and I kind of got the number. $2 for this. Happy. I was okay with that because it is issue 1 and it is a decent size issue. So I was like, $2 is not bad for this. I was happy with that. Probably because it was just bigger. And that's probably why it's $2. But I was okay with that. Picked that up. That was nice. The same person also had Justice Society America issue 2 for $1. So I picked this one up as well. Last time I think I saw this and I saw I had it. I actually checked and I did not have it. So this is another one. I can get off the list. So that's two comics. I'm cool to get off the list. Got that the same time I got the other stuff. Those two were from a different vendor. All the rest of this from the same vendor. Some of the stuff he had JSA. From the other guy who got the JSA and the birthday stuff from, he had Justice Society of America issue 18. That was cool. Another issue. He has that series. Nice. Also, he had another issue, Justice Society of America 21. That was nice. He had only those two, Justice Society of America. Both ones I needed, so I was happy with that. Two more to add to the collection. He also had another JSA book, JSA Strange Adventures issue 1. I really like the cover because it makes it look like an old kind of comic book cover kind of feel too, and I like that. But it's issue 1, I do have issue 2, that's why I picked this up. I really like this. It's a JSA, I think to me it's a mini series, not like a full on series. It could be, but I think it's just a mini series. I really like it. It has like an old school JSA feel to it, like it's back in like the old, it's not like the JSA or Society books by John Jones. It's like back in like when the old school JSA, back in their time, like when the USA was around fighting the war and all that kind of stuff. Like, you know, more back in the old, it was not like in modern times, so I do like that. It's set in like an older time, but I do like that for that series. It's actually really cool. Next is a series, this is probably the only other series I picked up more than two issues for. Everything else I picked up like an issue or two for. And that is Green Lantern Emerald Warrior. It's issue 1, it's $1. I really like this. It's probably one of my favorite Green Lantern comics to come out, newest ones. Especially if we're talking about before the New 52. This is probably my favorite because it's basically a Guy Gundam series. It's based on Guy Gundam. You know, he had a series back in the 90s, I think it's called Guy Gundam or something. I don't know what's called Guy Gundam. I think it's called Guy Gundam. And then we had Guy Gundam Warrior. So I like how they had Warrior in this, same as his old series, where it had Warrior in the title. I really like that. So that, I don't know if that's an intentional nod. But I do like that. But this is the first issue, and I didn't have this, so I was happy to get this for $1. Nice, it's also probably the brightest day, so that's cool. So I got that. Also got Green Lantern Emerald Warrior issue 2, also probably the brightest day. These have really nice covers, like I really like these covers. And this is probably one of my favorite Green Lantern books, it's not my favorite. It's not the longest, it's only like 13 issues, and that's not a lot. But it is probably my favorite Green Lantern book, because like I said, I like Guy Gunther. And it does have other characters in it too, it's not just him, because it does have other characters like Kilowog and stuff. So it is cool, and you see other lands in it, which is cool. That's another show I needed. We also had Green Lantern, Emerald Warrior, issue 3. Another one I needed for the collection. Another issue I was really happy with. Enjoy this book. So yeah, that was really nice. Also, they had Green Lantern, Emerald Warrior, issue 7. Another one I needed for the series. Is a prelude to the War of Green Lanterns. It was cool, I guess, as a prelude, I guess. It was okay. It wasn't amazing, I think, but it was good, I think. I guess I could see kind of as a prelude, I guess, to the War of Green Lanterns thing, which that was cool. I also had issue Green Lantern Warriors number 9. This is part of 6 of War of Green Lanterns, so tie-in issue. Have issue, was it 8? Yeah, 8. Already, and that's like part, I don't know, 3 or something. That's another part to the series, which is really cool. This is a cool crossover. This is the War of Green Lanterns, the last big crossover for the Green Lantern comic. Not counting any Flash Point stuff or anything, like the big crossover with all the Green Lantern books. Green Lantern Warrior, Green Lantern Core, and what's the other one? Green Lantern Core and Green Lantern, just Green Lantern. Squad Sub's Love free box. That was cool to get there. And also got issue 10 of Green Lantern Memorial. And then, so I'm not gonna say stuff like, yeah, what was the words together. Issue 10, this is part 9 of War of the Green Lantern, so it's cool. About to get, I think I have all the GSA crossovers of this. Of the, no, not GSA, what am I saying? Justice, the Green Lantern, Green Lantern Emma Warrior, I have all the Green Lantern Emma Warrior parts of War of the Green Lantern, plus there was one or two preview issues, I don't think so there was, to that. Also they had Green Lantern Emma Warrior issue 12. Another issue, that one I was kind of like, do I have this one, do I not? I actually did not have this one, so it's pretty cool. It's really cool, one of the good issue I think, just a single issue Green Lantern story, but I really like it. And yeah, really happy with that one, I didn't have it. I almost had the complete run of that series, only missing like one or two issues, so that's something I really have to look up for. I kind of did get complete because it's a one issue thing, it's a one shot. I got Brightest Day, the album special, CD1. This book I was really happy with, kind of a big fan of the album, and I didn't even know he had a special for Brightest Day, it was cool. But it does continue in even at the end it says, to be continued in Adventure Comics 516, so it does continue into that, so it's kind of, I'm not against that. I don't know how it continues to do it, if it's just part of that story or if it's another little story, I don't know. This is cool. I don't know if the anime has its own series at this point. In comics, I'm not sure. But you did have this, and it was actually really good. It does have a lot of origins, like the origins and all of this in a good way. And it's also by written by Jeff Lemire, so that gives it like 100 minutes to my department. In my department, he's up there with Jeff Johns, Grant Morrison, like one of the writers, so I was like, okay, that's cool. I didn't know that until after I had the book on that, and I was like, oh, that's awesome. The meaning a lot of Jeff Lemire stuff. Cool. Next we have The Flash, issue 3, was part of Brightest Day as well. A lot of Brightest Day stuff. They had a lot of Brightest Day stuff, so it's cool. Issue 3 of The Flash. I'm a fan of The Flash. Everybody knows I watched the show, it's amazing. This comic is actually one of the best Flash comics, I think, out. Oh, that's one of the best ones before the new 52. Maybe the new one's pretty good, but I like this is probably one of my favorites. Up to one of my favorite Flash book, this is issue 3. It was written by Jeff Johns. He was writing a lot of good books back then. Right before the New 52 started, he was like, he was writing a lot of books. Flash, Green Lantern, he was writing Fight Zed. Actually, he got to learn. He got to learn a lot. And he probably was writing many more. We have Flash issue 4, Lost World by this day. Another issue that I was happy to get, I didn't have. I really like this series. The art is one thing I really like about this. I don't know, it just has a feel to it that feels like the Flash. It makes it feel like I don't know why, but when I see this art, someone reminds me of the Flash like TV show or something. I don't know, it has that like a kind of like the Flash TV show feel to it when I read it. Cause this art really works because I'm seeing it. I don't know, it reminds me of the TV show. Like I'm reading 3D issues and it reminds me somehow of the art kind of. I don't know, it has that makes it feel like the TV show for some. If you kinda get what I mean, it feels like the TV show. Almost done here, we have two more single issues. Justice League, Jameson Lott, issue 1, you also had that. So I picked that up. It's also part of Brightest Day too, so that was nice. This is another comic I've been reading. I got an issue of it, and I grabbed it back and then I got another issue of it, and I really enjoyed the series. Because it's based kind of like on the original. Has four other members of the original Justice League. From like Justice League International and stuff like that, I remember that time. The original Justice League International, Justice League Europe, Justice League, like characters from that. And everybody knows, those are like my favorite Justice League comics, so having them brought back in a series kind of, it's not every member, but it's like all these are like some of the members that you remember from that series, like Ice, Fire, Booster Gold, who's the other one, Author of Skeets, and we have, I guess it's with Booster Gold and Captain Atom, but then I know Blue Beetle comes into the series, the new Blue Beetle has the other one guy. This is actually really cool and I like this, this is, also Macro Ability D1 on this, so yeah, so 5th issue Generation Lost, happy, actually that was really good, 5th issue planning, everything, and then we got Justice League Generations Lost issue 2. Was nice. Next one's cool, it also says the new Blue Beetle down the bottom, and next one at the end of it has the new Blue Beetle, so that was kind of cool. And I guess maybe he has something to do with it. I don't know how he was protected, or how everybody else was in, or how he knows about it. Or maybe he believes them, because I don't know. So I would like to actually see more of the series. This is actually one of my favorite comics that came out and come to Bright Day. Bringing back a series, kind of like bringing back a lot of characters. And Booster Gold actually had, I think, a series on this time too, so that was kind of really cut. Because it's actually a series, because it's like, it comes out, it's like a has a late and early thing, and I know there's a lot, there's actually a decent amount of issues to this, so there's actually a decent amount of issues to this. So it is a comic that actually am going to be getting more of this. Definitely want to get a Kazuma of this one. I think the ones higher than log. This is actually a Saber Kazuma, so it looks like it's might be upon its brightest day or something like that. Again, last thing I got, all of this guy's stuff's on like 50% off if you get that. Everything, like, if you get over 100 comics, they're $1, and they're like 50% off. Like, when I got this 50% off, he had a graphic novel. That's one I actually been wanting to read. It is Time Masters graphic novel, the one about featuring 52 Swift Hunter. It is featuring 52 Swift Hunter. Is this Swift Hunter from the 52? It says 52 featuring 52 Swift Hunter. I don't know what that means. That means from the 52 is, I don't know. This contains the complete, let me see the services here. What is it? 8-issue mini-series called Time Master. Actually, it was really happy to get this. I'm a big fan of the goal and all that, so I know a lot about Swift Hunter. He's a cool character and he's in Legends of Tomorrow now. This before Legends of Tomorrow, I think, was announced and stuff when I got this. Or wasn't something I knew too much about, but I really wanted to get this. But then it has a bonus comic in the beginning. But it's part of an issue of Secret Origins, I think that relates to this and that, but other than my way, that's cool. Yeah, so the book, I got like, how much was this? Like, I think $5, $10? It's like, either $5? Like, $10? I mean, I got it really cheap, like, it was like maybe $5. Or something, it wasn't that expensive, like, the full price for this book wasn't, it's not that bad, like, less than like $10, and even that, it's not too bad. For a book that was like 1999 or something, it's under $10, I know that. It was $10 longer and I got it really cheap. I think 50% off means I got it for like $5. I mean, I got it really cheap, so I was really happy with this. So I was really happy to have this. And now this is up on my graphic novel shelf. Usually, that stuff stays down here until I film it. So, now this is going on my graphic novel shelf. So really happy. That's probably the coolest thing I got. If you guys are watching this video, if you guys like it, you can like it and add to your favorite. If you want to check out my main channel, Super Creative Boomer, where there's skits, parodies, animation, all kinds of good stuff, you can subscribe to the channel. You can always stay back to your next video. Bye, guys!